talk about information and privacy and what the government can look at and what they can't. And this is surrounding the world's biggest search engine, Google, and some new privacy changes they're making, which has people up in arms. So I want to cover all angles of this, and I want to do it with an expert. We're going to do it with the best here. The best, of course, being Bill Kerrigan, CEO of ABINE, Abine, which you can reach at abine.com. It's a company that enhances online privacy. He's also the former executive vice president of McAfee, which everybody knows, antivirus, software protection, all of that. Bill, welcome. It's a pleasure to have you.
Thanks, Andy. Great to be with you.
Okay, very cool. Now, Bill, paint us a picture as to the changes that Google is about to make. Set up the entire world. Before we get into the argument, I just want to know what we're dealing with, if you could. So go ahead.
Well, sure. The lack of online privacy is a big problem today, and it's getting worse. You know, we're talking about Google, but on the same side, we have the Facebook IPO coming. We have Zappos, right? They just lost millions and millions of customer records and personal information here. So the reality is consumers should be aware about how much information they have out there about them on the net. And the recent changes with Google is they're going to be collecting that information now across all of their services, search, email, YouTube.
Okay. Now, they used to be divided into buckets, Bill. Like if you went to YouTube, you went to Gmail. These were different identities, so to speak. Walk us through what Google's actually doing to make all of this more streamlined, which helps them sell advertising. But the negative is it's tracking people across the web. Can you explain that?
Sure. And, you know, as a consumer brand, we appreciate building an elegant service, but not at the expense of consumer privacy. Google going forward will be collecting personal information across all of their boundaries. And what's probably most troubling to us is there's not a clear ability for a consumer to opt out of that tracking.
Okay. Now, there's a lawsuit going on here because Google wants to implement this stuff starting March 1st. And according to what I'm seeing, the Electronic Privacy Information Center is suing the United States Federal Trade Commission over Google's plans to streamline this privacy. Essentially, the EPIC, this privacy group, is saying to the federal government, hey, you, the federal government, promised that Google would behave and not do this type of thing. Now Google's doing it. Where do you think this lawsuit's going to end up? Who wins this? Does it delay Google? Does it stop Google? What's going on?
Well, certainly we're glad to see the FTC involved. They are on the side of the consumer and are obligated to not only advocate on our behalf, but also protect all of us. I believe at the end of the day, this is a problem that will be better solved by technology rather than legislation. How do we give consumers very easy-to-use privacy tools that gives control back to them?
Okay. Now, does this apply to Google search engine? Because I use Chrome. And I visit a lot of sites I probably shouldn't. If my management knew about it, they would fire me. How does that work?
Andy, this goes not only across the search engine and across all of the Google properties, but also think about the other big player in this discussion, Facebook. Any place you see a Facebook like button on the web, they have the capability of also tracking and collecting data about you. So when we're talking about Google specifically today, the picture is much broader, and consumers should be concerned about how all web properties are collecting their data. We think we've got to give consumers very simple and easy-to-use tools that allow them to understand who's tracking them and how they can block that tracking and still use the internet.
Okay. And people just joining us, talking to Bill Kerrigan, online privacy expert, formerly worked at McAfee and now the CEO of Abine. Am I saying that right, Abine?
That works well for us.
Okay, very good.
Abine.com.
Okay, very good. Now, I want to ask you, Bill, a question, because I'm going to take the other side of this. Online privacy really hasn't mattered much to me, but maybe that's my personality. I mean, I'm in the air 3 hours a day, so I don't really care what people think. But for those that do, I want to ask this question. You know, isn't it almost death by overinformation? The fact that we go to so many websites every day, who really cares if we're being tracked? I mean, I understand if, you know, an international terrorist, I understand why they're concerned, and I think they should be, and I think we should track them. But for your average regular guy, you know, you go to 9-to-5 work or whatever, or you're a truck driver, and you surf the net on your mobile phone. Why do I care if Google's aggregating all this stuff? How could it ever be used against me? I don't get the other side, all these privacy experts who are so obsessed with protecting privacy. Isn't there so much information out there, even aggregating it and distilling it? How do you ever do that?
Well, look, consumers do care, Andy. We recently conducted a poll of 1,000 internet users. Over 70% of them said they wanted more control over how their data is collected and used at this time. You know, there is a consequence to all this data collection. The negative results can be as benign as embarrassment or as tangible and real as a reduced credit score rating, loss of employment, or becoming the victim of an identity theft crime. So the consequences are real. Consumers are becoming more aware. It's up to them to be proactive.
Right, so, Bill, are you saying Google, if regarding your credit rating, Google can tell your credit company what sites you're visiting, what type of information you're exploring, all of that? That can happen?
The data collection today that occurs on the web occurs at an enormous level, where all of your site visits, all the web properties, where you're looking at different things is all tracked and collected and used, not only for targeted advertising, but multiple other uses.
Okay. And then what is it, a machine that's doing all this? They're not like a bunch of humans sitting in a big room that could ever deal with this much data. So all the machines aggregate it and they realize, hey, if you're visiting a tennis website, they were going to give you an ad next time you're on Facebook for a tennis racket. I mean, is it machine? This is all machines, right? It's like the Matrix.
Well, it's not only all machines, it's multiple companies and over 200 of them that are developing tracking technologies that are on your devices collecting that information. So it's not just one company doing it. It's multiple companies now who are aggregating data, collecting that data, profiling you, and even trading data across the net. We think it's far too much of a concentration of personal information in one place in the case of Google or Facebook. Consumers need the ability to either opt out clearly of those services and the tracking mechanisms or have the ability to block that tracking at their discretion.
Okay, now, Bill, I have one final question, and then we're up against a break here, but I'd love to get your answer to this. Let's say Google's allowed to go ahead with this because of the complexity. You know, nobody in Washington really understands it. They somehow manage to get past this lawsuit, and they implement essentially the streamlined way to collect all your information online. Is there anything that anybody can do to protect themselves? Because, you know, like, for instance, the group here, our producers, they visit a lot of, you know, adult content, that type of stuff. Is there anything that you can do to protect yourself online so you're not getting tracked? Or once you're on Google, that's it. If you use Gmail and YouTube, everybody knows what you're doing, and that's it. Sayonara.
No, Andy, we've launched a product that users can use to do everything they would normally do online with no disruption.
Okay.
But at the same time, it stops advertisers like Google and Facebook from knowing everything you can do. You can come and see us at abeen.com and download Do Not Track Plus to get control back over your personal information.
All right, Bill, we're going to call that a day, my friend. Bill Kerrigan, thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
Andy, thanks.
Okay, cool. All right, we'll take your phone calls to close out the program.